Hey YouTube, Copper San here. Welcome back to our reboot progression series. In a recent update, reboot players have gotten a massive buff, so it's time to go bossing. The most OP and highly skilled bossing duo is back. Femke and I are playing on a Shade and Paladin that usually hit like wet noodles, but a recent update has had some very interesting implications for both our characters. The Glimpse of Joy update did make me lose some hair because of some of those bugs, and I'm not too sure about those Kana buffs, but hey, who am I to question Nexon's game balancing choices? But more importantly, with this update, the reboot passive skill, that one skill that every reboot player gets, has been changed to now give final damage instead of just damage. And this change is freaking massive. Well, before the update, it took us 5 whole minutes to take down this big angry Kaelswurm. After the update, our completion time was about halved. Life is looking good on the reboot server. Well, at least everything is looking good on the e-reboot server. Not too sure about those NA servers, to be honest. But just look at this madness. It used to take 90 seconds for me and Femke to duo the queen, but now I can defeat her even faster without having to gang up on her with an invincible paladin by my side. Bossing in reboot is absolutely free right now. Alright, so this video is part of our reboot progression series, so there has to be some progression shots in there as well. First of all, to start it off, I trained a bit and started farming for mesos because I always seem to run out of those. We have been making some progress with our gear and we're getting more and more absolute pieces every week. We took down Lotus for the first time a few weeks ago and we took down Damien last week as well. Pretty awesome, right? Well, for me this is actually pretty bad because I have absolutely no self-control when it comes to my gear. The hardest thing in reboot is being patient with your mesos and not just going ham on the very next item that you get. I still don't have any meso gear and it's really hurting my raids, but that fat damage that I'm doing right now really makes me sleep peaceful at night. There are a few very important meso draining events coming real soon, so I'm spending most of my time grinding, completing Maple Tour, doing Ursus runs and bossing just to get as many mesos as I can. The 5-10-15 Starforce event will be held on the 28th of November as a part of the Sunny Sunday events. This event is mostly used for getting items to 17 stars, and the upcoming Friday there's also a sale on cubes, which would be great for me to finally get some meso gear, but I think I can get even more stat wise from just starforcing my gear to 17 stars. And there also is a Word of Double Miracle Time being held later this year as well, so there are plenty of things to save mesos for, but I'm not sure what to pick. I might actually just save up mesos for cubes and then starforce later so I can finally get some meso gear so I can get more mesos. What do you think, YouTube? Let me know. Should I farm for meso gear or should I just increase my stats even more so I can slap some bosses even harder? I think the answer is actually pretty obvious. It's probably meso gear, but let me know what you think. Also, if you are enjoying today's video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more MapleStory content. Make sure to hit the bell notification as well to stay up to date when new videos go live. Also, I didn't only get Absolute pieces, I also got a lucky drop from Helix the other day. After Femke got sabotaged by our cat, who decided that her keyboard was the perfect spot to take a nap on exactly during the fight, she tapped out and I was left with a glorious Golex belt. That's at least one item of the Golex set complete. And this is last week's Damien fight before the changes, and while that plays out, a word of advice for everyone who's progressing a reboot. Our route to Absolute might have been a bit longer than others, because Femke and I always want to first duo bosses together before we go with other people, before we go in parties. But I noticed that there is quite a gap in being able to defeat the kills through the Abyss bosses and being able to defeat Damien and Lotus. So if you are at this in-between point as well, progression is slowing down, don't worry, this is absolutely normal. MapleStory is all about that longer term progress. If you cannot get carries or want to progress to get absolute gear on your own strength, it just takes a bit more time. Unless you're an OP Adele or a godly farmer like Kana, I guess. Getting absolute gear is also highly dependent on your scrapyard and demon camp weeklies, so make sure to do those as often as possible. The items you can get from your weeklies can be transferred within your account, so you can also get them on multiple characters to get them even faster. The earlier you start doing this, the better. Thanks to all our upgrading and bossing, we're even stronger now and reach 20k stats when fully buffed, which is already higher than my main Illuna, that Demon Slayer. That's pretty crazy actually. To give a better idea of just how much faster we're bossing right now, here's a compilation of me and Femke Paladin beating up some bosses.
Hammer here say, oh!
Looking at how far we've come, I'm definitely very happy with the progress we've been making. That is definitely one of the advantages of playing a reboot, the progression feels very satisfying. This is my gear right now. We will go over most items pretty quickly because not that much has changed. I think most of them are the same, but I did get that new Golex belt that gives 12% strength. I have now Absalab shoes that give 14% strength, Absalab gloves with 8% crit damage, which is a must-have stat. I got some Absalab shoulders that give 70% strength, and I have the cape as well now that gives 20% strength. And so we now have the 5-piece Absalab set effect going as well. I still need to replace my weapon as this is an event item that cannot be upgraded, so that's up next. And thanks to a bit more leveling, I also reached 7.5k Legion, aiming to get 8k by the end of the year. Femke also improved a lot thanks to the addition of some new Absalab pieces, and she got really lucky and found a Dominate Dependent from Arcarium. She reached about 17k stats right now and is getting closer to her Luna Paladin stats, who had around 29k strength. We also tried to defeat Easy Lucid, but we need a slight stat increase of about double our stats to even attempt that properly. So looking for a party. Anyone wants to do Easy Lucid in the EU reboot? And that was all for today. I hope you enjoyed today's episode of the Reboot Progression Series. We finally reached 20k stats and we can do bosses a lot easier now thanks to our gear gains and also thanks to the Reboot passive change. And as always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Comic, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Riley Oss, Terry Kim, Varese, Dries Sumker, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, Saffronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Almar NHI, Frank Bouguette, Ziggy Deer, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Knifesu, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, SirTito655, Grayson Lee, Brandon Cam, Vira, Trevor, Michael Machaca, Ratius, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zhang, Afterlord_MS, Heopon, Simak20, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, NockMSS, Niu, Taido and Pam, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kusumo Vegas, Ricer RU, Andy Harem, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, Liron Rattle, and Booty Warrior GT. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling!